Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I thought that I would vlog a little bit over the next couple of days because I haven't vlogged in a really, really long time. I'm going to be filming part of this vlog on my Canon and then the other part's going to be on my phone. So I do apologize for the quality change. I know that that's kind of annoying. However, I am going to get a vlogging camera this year at some point. I don't know whether to get the Canon G7X or the Sony A500 or the A5100. Let me know in the comments if you have either of those and if you prefer one rather than the other. I think I'm more leaning towards the Sony, but I do want to get a vlogging camera this year, but it will be a little bit later on because I just have other priorities at the moment. But I really wanted to do a little bit of a vlog for you guys. So I've just finished filming a video. Did I just mention like why I'm filming with two different cameras? I'm filming with my Canon when I'm like at home and stuff like that, just because the quality is a lot better and I hate the quality of iPhone vlogs. And also my phone storage always fills up really quick. So if I vlog too much on my phone, I don't have enough storage to finish the vlog off. So I'm filming part of this video on my Canon and then the other part's going to be on the phone when I'm out and about. I do apologize for that, but it's just what I have to do at the moment because I just can't really vlog completely with my phone. But anyways, yes, I just finished filming a video. I think I may be going to Cotton On today because I need to find some high-necked tops because I don't know if you guys can see. I'm not going to show you guys the complete thing, but I'm really, really burnt. I have the worst tan line and I'm peeling just in a little square here, like a little round kind of, it's actually like a round little shape that I have where I was wearing a singlet top the other day. God sake, hate it. I was literally not even out at the beach. I was at a cafe with a friend. It was sunny. We were there for about an hour and a half and I wasn't wearing sunscreen and I got burnt right where the singlet top was. I didn't even get burnt on my arms, just in that area. What the fuck is my life? Fuck summer, I hate you so much. I wanted to tell you guys about a very, 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 very exciting thing that is happening tomorrow on Tuesday. By the way, it's so funny, I actually have my Canon on my tripod, so I really don't even need to hold it. I can just sit here like this, but I feel because it's a vlog, I feel like I should be like holding it because I feel like awkward just sitting here and like talking as if it's a main channel video. So, you guys are literally going to die. For quite a while I've wanted to go blonde and last year around like March or April I think it was, I know it was before May, but March or April, I went to two different hair salons to take me from dark brown to blonde and they completely stuffed my hair up. I have two vlogs which I will link below so that you guys can watch that whole process if you want. The first one was just called I'm Going Blonde and the second one was What Have They Done, and my hair was so disgusting. So I ended up dyeing my hair back to brown because they just did a really awful job. It wasn't even like, oh, it's, you know, that's what's going to happen going from brown to blonde. It was absolutely disgusting. And all of you guys that watched those vlogs told me, like, they had done such a terrible job. Like, they are so unprofessional. So I ended up dyeing my hair back to brown. And I haven't dyed my hair in months. I don't actually know when the last time I did it, but I think it may have been August of last year. So it's been a very long time since I've dyed my hair. My hair has, I haven't touched it in a while because my plan was basically to not dye my hair for ages, get it healthy, get like, you know, not add any more color to it, and then go blonde sometime this year. My roots are like an ashy brown, which is my natural hair color. My this like middle part of my hair is still really dark brown, and then the ends of my hair, I don't know if you, oh, you can't tell because I'm wearing my extensions, but the ends of my hair are like a caramel color. So I have three different shades going on in my hair and I've tried really hard to just put up with it for a while, but now it's getting to the point where it just looks really bad. Putting my hair down, I can't even wear my hair extensions. It just looks really, really terrible. So I was sitting there the other day and I was like, you know what, Jess, you want to change, you want to go blonde, stop just thinking about it and just make the appointment. So I'm going to WAK, the salon in Newcastle tomorrow, which is where Brittany Saunders goes to get her hair done. I have full faith in them. I don't think that my hair is going to be, I mean, it may be a blonde shade. I don't think it's obviously not going to be the exact blonde that I want after the first go. I mean, I don't know, but I'm sure that won't be the case, especially because I do have product build up and I had like three different shades and I'm sure it's going to be very, very annoying for them. I do apologize in advance. but I have full faith in them. I know that they do a really, really good job with blondes, and they're just a professional hair salon. They have, like, I think that Wade, the owner of the salon, is like the most awarded hair stylist in Newcastle, so I know that it's a really, really good salon, and I'm just so excited. So I had to vlog my trip there, and I had to vlog how it looks and kind of take you guys on my new hair journey, because once I start going blonde this time, I'm not going to stop. I'm going to push through, because if I keep just going back to brown just because I'm impatient, then I'm never going to be blonde. So I'm so excited. I can't wait for you guys to see. Also, I just wanted to show you guys this new purse that I got. I was contacted by this company called Teddy Blake, and I'm going to do like a what's in my bag video, so I'm not going to talk about it too much, but they are a brand that kind of mimics designer handbags. So this bag that they sent me is a duplicate of a Hermes bag, but it's their own brand, like Teddy Blake brand. It's not like fake stuff, but it's real Italian leather, and I was very grateful that they wanted to send me one, because it's just absolutely gorgeous. So it comes in this, I just thought I'd like show you guys, even though I'm gonna do like a what's in my bag, but it comes in this like gold duster bag or whatever they're called. It is so gorgeous. I love the color. It's in dark beige. It's the Katie Stampato for a 12 inch bag. This is my first ever really, really good quality handbag that I've ever owned, and inside is like, I think it's suede. Goes to show how much I know about materials. Got a text. This is an appointment reminder from WAK Salon. I have to go take Instagram photos now because you know, but also, is that light gonna turn on? Hello? Just in my bathroom right now, but I just have to go take Instagram photos, but I just thought I'd show you guys that recently, this is like wet and dirty, so I do apologize, but recently I got sent the High Smile teeth whitening kit. And unfortunately, I haven't been using it every single day because I just get so lazy sometimes, but I have two of them, so I'll let you guys know how it goes. I'll be doing a video on it, demonstrating how to use it and everything like that, but it is the same teeth whitening kit that Kylie Jenner uses, so bitch, if you wrong about it, ask the weird guard, catch me outside. Oh, that's really actually makes me look tanned in that lighting, except for the fact I have a really awful tan line. But yes, yeah, so anyways, I'm just about to go take some Instagram photos, and then I am going to probably go to Cotton On to see if I can find a top, and then I'm going to have to edit. I'm trying to take photos out on my balcony because it's like really good lighting and the wind, and every time I try to like do like a good like face, like the wind and the sun like gets my eyes, and I'm like Instagram worthy. I feel like this like balcony always reminds me of Shani Grimmond, how she always like does it outside and like you can see like the background, and I love that so much. It's just the lighting is so good, but it's so hard to get a bloody good photo because of the bloody sun. I'm shedding. I hope that's my actual like extensions and not my real hair. Can't be doing that. Gotta go blonde bastards. Hey guys, so I'm just at the shopping center right now, so I'm just about to go into Cotton On to try and find some tops. I really just do not like black on me. I feel like it makes me look so pale. I'm just like complaining about everything recently with my appearance, but I just feel like black makes me look so pale and like sickly. So I'm going to look for like some lighter colored, like nude, beige, white type of tops, because I'm honestly not a fan of black. I really don't like wearing it. It makes me look so pale when I'm not. But anyways, I'm really worried about my phone mount because I think it's so hot that it just peels off of my windscreen. So when I have like my phone up with the map showing and everything, it literally just peels off of the windscreen because it's that hot. So I'm really hoping that it doesn't do that tomorrow because I need to know where I'm going, like I need to use maps, and it's like that hot that it's peeling off of the actual like windscreen and like falling off. I need my maps. I can't be having it falling off and like holding my phone because I've already been pulled over enough this bloody week and fortnight. Anyway, so yeah, I'm just about to go in, so I'll show you guys what I get in there. Hopefully I can find something. Pray for me. Camera change, back to better quality. So anyways, I just went to Cotton On and I was literally only in there for like 10 minutes, which is so good. I ended up getting this top, which you can really see on my bed like that. But it's basically just this like white off the shoulder top. I just got out of the hair salon. I look a little bit like sweaty and whatever, but holy crap. I went in there and I was like, I showed him a picture and I was like, yeah, I want my hair sort of like this eventually. And he's like, yeah, that's fine. It'll probably be a light brown with like lighter bits in it this time. And I'm like, okay. And then he was doing my hair and I didn't know like what to expect. Like I had no idea what to expect. And then I was sitting in the basin getting my hair washed. It is so bloody hot. I'm sitting in the basin getting my hair washed and I'm like, a little piece of hair flew over my face and I've looked at it and I'm like, wow, that's really, really blonde. And I'm like, it's quite bleached, like looks quite yellow. And then when he was blow drying my hair, I didn't know what to expect because my roots look lighter and then I still look like I had a lot of brown and then blonde ends. Like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, this is literally, I can't believe, like, I'm sorry if I'm getting like emotional, but you guys know after the last time I went to the hair salon, those two last times, and they told me like, oh, your hair's gonna look like that, like that's how your hair's gonna look. No, bitch, this is how my hair is meant to look. Like, I can't believe that this is the first session. So anyways, he told me to come back in 6 weeks and he'll focus more on the top. What do you guys think? I'm literally in love with it, and I just rang my friend and I was so emotional. I can't get over how good it looks. Anyways, I'm gonna vlog when I get home. I'll show you guys. I got two little like products as well, so I'll show you guys when I get back. I'm in love with it. I love that hair salon so much. Hey guys, so it's actually the next day after I got my hair done. Basically, when I got home, I did vlog a little bit of footage for my hair, but pretty much I was just filming a video and my like card ran out of storage, so I had to delete it, and so I didn't actually import it onto my computer. So just thought I would update you guys on my hair. It is so bloody hot. Yeah, I'm just really, really happy with how it turned out. As I said, I think I mentioned in the last clip of my vlog that I will be going back in 6 weeks' time to get a new, to get lighter, and he's mainly gonna focus on like the roots and the top half of my hair. You can see from the back like how light it is, but yeah, I'm really, really happy with it. I mean, even though it's not 100% full blonde, which of course it wasn't going to be, it looks good. And that's what I was trying to say, was that like with my last hair salon, it like looked so terrible that I couldn't even deal with it, whereas this actually looks like a nice color. Like, you can, you know, you can work with it, it's fine, like there's nothing wrong with it. It may be a little bit warm in certain areas where I had that really dark brown, but it's like, you can work with it, it looks nice. It's not like, oh my god, I don't want to leave the house. Just so glad that I went to that hair salon and went and took the trip to there, because they definitely know what they're doing. But anyways, it is so hot, so I'm going to end this vlog here. I hope you guys enjoyed this little vlog and my little process of brunette to blonde, which definitely wasn't as long of a process as I thought, but that is basically it. I hope you guys enjoy and I will see you all in my next video. I really wish that this is my house. I'm actually at my mum's house right now because I have a pest spray going on and I couldn't film there and I wanted to film today. So I really wish I had something like this in my house, like a little white wall like this. Cute, eh? And I will see you all in my next video. Bye.